What is it? What is it? Why is this good, the Ahmari?
Go.
What is this good?
I love you, bro.
You can say.
This good?
Jesus
this
said,
good?
I am the light of the world.
Why?
You need light.
Liar.
You need light.
Liar.
What does the Quran teach
liar.
About the Prophet Muhammad?
Muhammad number one before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
How many wives did he have? How many wives did he have?
Wife?
How many wives?
Wife.
In the Quran, how many wives are you supposed to have?
I don't know.
Four.
What was?
How many wives did he have?
I'm the wife.
Jesus said,
listen!
Jesus said, I am the light of the world.
Okay, why?
Why? You need light.
Why not marry?
You need light.
Why?
You need
why
light.
Not marry?
You need the light in your life. Jesus is the light.
Muhammad, Ibrahim,
and
Musa, Isa, Sulaiman, all.
The world.
All marry.
The world.
Not Jesus. Not Jesus.
The world is walking in darkness.
Not marry. Why?
The world is walking in
why?
Darkness. The world is walking in darkness.
You liar.
And we need light.
Liar.
And Jesus is the light.
Liar.
He's the one to be praised. He's
liar.
The one to be worshipped. He's the one to be honored. He's the one to be glorified.
Liar.
Where's Muhammad now?
Muhammad for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Where is it?
Muhammad for Allah subhanahu
Muslims,
wa ta'ala.
Where is it? He's dead. Jesus died and rose again.
Where your
he died and rose again.
Where your father?
He said, I am the resurrection and
where
the life. He's come to give your life new power in your life.
Liar.
New joy in your
liar.
Life. New power, sir.
Liar.
New life
liar.
In your
soul.
Life and power in your life. Joy in your life. That's what you can have in Jesus. He can set you free. He can set you free, my friend, and give you new life and new joy today. If you want to know Jesus, all you got to do is confess. Say, I'm sorry for my sin, and put your faith in Jesus, and He'll be your Savior. Do it while you can, because there is a hell. There is a hell. There is a judgment. If you sow badness, you'll get judged for it. And then there is a judgment day. So trust Him while you can. Trust Him while you can. Trust Him while you can. He is the way, the truth, and the life. He is the light of the world. He is the bread of life. He can give you joy and power and hope in your life. My friend, you need Jesus Christ. He'll give you new life, new hope, new power. He'll quicken you out of darkness into new life. The world is passing away. The wrath of God is upon the world. He's coming. The wrath of God is coming. The last days, it said, there'll be more wars, there'll be more rumors of wars, there'll be more earthquakes in the last days. We see more earthquakes, we see more wars, and the Bible is true. And Jesus said that He'll come back. And when He comes back, will you believe, or will you walk the way of the world? Now is the time of salvation, now is the day of salvation, now is the time to come to Him. Now is the time to find peace. Now is the time to find hope. Jesus said, I am the vine, and you are the branches, and you cannot bear fruit unless you're in the vine. You cannot bear fruit unless you're in Jesus. You cannot bear fruit unless you're in Him. 216 times. 216 times. 216 times in the Bible. 216 times in the Bible, it says this, in Christ, you've got to be in Christ. If you're not in Christ, you're in the devil. If you're not in Christ, you're in the way of the world. If you're not in Christ, you're in the way of man. You need to be in Christ and have that new life, that new hope, that new vision in your life. That God can fill you with His love, that God can fill you with His joy, that God can fill you with His power. And then you can be born again by the power of the Holy Ghost. Born again with new life. Where you can love God, praise God, worship God. Because the Holy Spirit is in your life. Jesus Christ gave His life for you on that cross. There's a story of a millionaire. I've said this before, but there's a story of a millionaire. And his son died in the First World War. And he was broken-hearted, so he had a portrait done of him, a picture.
That what you said it before?
Yeah, I'm saying it again.
Change the topic.
It's a good story. He had this picture done of his son. And on one day, the picture was not very good. One day the millionaire died. And all the family were greedy and they came for the money. And the solicitor said, before I read the will out, we're going to sell this picture, auction it. And there, the picture of the millionaire's son, it was scruffy, wasn't worth much. No one would buy it, no one bothered to buy it. Well, the cleaner did, the janitor did, he bought it for a few pounds. Then the solicitor said this, he said, the millionaire says this, the one who bought my son's picture inherits everything. My friends, if you have Jesus Christ, the Father's Son, you inherit everything. If you don't have the Son, you don't have anything. If you have the Son, you have everything. Jesus Christ said that He is the light. He said, I am the resurrection and the life. He said, I am the bread of life. He said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. He said these things. He pointed to Himself. He pointed to Himself. In a second, you can ask a question. I'll let you ask a question in a minute. He pointed to Himself. No prophet pointed to themselves. They pointed to God, but He pointed to Himself. There's only one way to be saved, and that's in Jesus Christ. Not Muhammad, not Buddha, not atheism. The only way to be saved is in Him. I know this. I know the forgiveness. In 1 John chapter 1, verse 9, it says, if you confess your sin, He is faithful and just to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Are your sins forgiven?
What?
Are your sins forgiven?
My sins? They could be forgiven.
You don't know. See, we know, friend. It says, if you confess your sins, He is faithful and just to cleanse you from all. Listen, He is faithful and just to cleanse you from all unrighteousness. So, it's the Word of God saying that if you confess your sin and believe that Jesus died for you, you can be forgiven. Because when Jesus died on that cross,
I didn't know He died.
I'll come back to it in a minute. That's a good question. When Jesus died on that cross, He died as a murderer, but He never murdered. He died as a thief, but He never thieved.
Injustice.
He died for you. No, because in Isaiah 53, the Word of God in Isaiah 53, the prophet says, and you believe the prophets. The prophet said this: He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon Him. By His stripes we are healed. The Lord has laid on Him the iniquity of us all. That is a prophecy. 800 years before Jesus, it was prophesied that He would die on a cross for you, my friend. Now, what did you want to ask me?
I want to ask you, did Jesus have a God? So Jesus said, I'm returning to your God and my God.
Okay, let me.
Did Jesus have a God?
All right.
And He returned to God.
I'll answer your question. One times one times one is what?
Why times it? No.
Let me show you. One times one times one. What is it?
One plus what is
it? No, come on. One times one times one is what? Answer the question.
Why multiply?
You're not being honest. Just answer the question.
One.
Why, right. So you got three ones and one, right? So don't come this one. No, you Muslims come. One plus one plus one is three. I'm giving it you another mathematical way. One times one times one is one. So you can have three in one.
Three in one, yeah,
show me anywhere in the world. Show me anywhere in the world where you can have one essence and no difference within the essence. Name me one thing.
So there's a difference in the essence. Yeah? Let me just say, I'll accept the argument. Yeah? Right. The difference in the essence, one is superior, so the one that is superior is the one that you're supposed to pray to, right?
No.
So Jesus prayed to the superior
one. You're talking double. Okay, ask the question. Name me one essence in the universe.
Even for the sake of argument.
Name me one essence in the universe where there is no difference within it.
I said, for the sake of argument, I agree with you.
Right, okay, so end of debate.
Jesus,
end
God,
of debate,
right?
End of debate,
God,
end of debate.
Which is superior.
Reality that we know that within reality, we have one and the many. Within God, we have one and three.
So
wait a minute. Mathematically, you have not dealt with it. Philosophically, we've not dealt with it. Now let's get to your scripture. In your scripture, in the Quran. Wait a minute. In your Quran, it says that God is the beginning and the end, right? That is what the names of the 99 names of Allah, yeah? That God is the beginning and the end. Jesus said, I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning,
He said He's the beginning and the end.
Wait, Omega,
right?
Let me finish.
Not only Jesus that said that.
Let me finish.
Other people that said that.
I've shown mathematically, philosophically, and from your own Quran that Jesus is God.
Jesus is the only one that said
end of debate.
Alpha
end
Omega.
Of debate.
Jesus, is the only
Jesus
one that said
have you ever lied?
Jesus is the only one that said
have
that.
Have you ever lied?
I lied.
Right. How do you know you're going to be forgiven on the day of judgment?
Because I ask God to forgive me. If I ask the Father to forgive me,
forgive the
and I pray like Jesus prayed, and I ask the Father to forgive me. Will the Father not forgive me?
Have you got forgiveness now?
I believe the Father forgave me.
Have you got forgiveness now?
I believe I did.
You haven't. Jesus Christ, because I know my sins are forgiven, because I know that he died for me. Jesus said this from his own lips, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whoever believes on him shall not perish but have everlasting life.
Wait a minute. God had sex with Mary.
Listen.
It's not for that. That's a big blasphemy.
No,
for me that's a huge blasphemy.
The Greek word for begotten can mean only, so it means one and only, right?
It doesn't mean sex.
No, it doesn't mean that. No, listen to the Greek. One and only. Jesus said this. He said, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whoever believes on him shall not perish but have everlasting life.
For the people at that time,
no, not
him, right?
For you.
Jesus, why only me? Why about Moses?
Listen, it's for you. Listen, for God so loved the world. Are you in the world?
Yeah.
Right. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whoever believes on him shall not perish but have everlasting life.
You believe in Jesus as well.
I'm not disagreeing with you.
You do believe in Jesus. No, and we love Jesus more than you love Jesus.
You don't worship Jesus.
You don't worship even Muhammad.
Paul said, every knee shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Jesus is Lord.
Why?
You have, because he is the Son of God.
Okay, wait, let me say this here. Jesus came out of a woman.
He is the Son of God, sir.
He came out of a woman.
Jesus is the Son of God who died for you. He is the Son of God who gave his life. He is the Son of God who gives you peace and joy. He is the Son of God who gives you power. He is the Son of God who gives you hope. He is the Son of God who gives you strength. He is the Son of God. No man was like him. No man in history was like him. Nobody influenced history like Jesus Christ. Nobody influenced science, philosophy, anything like Jesus Christ. He is the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. And one day he's coming back. One day he's coming back. And when he comes back, when he comes back, you got to trust him. You got to look to him. You got to believe in him. You got to do it now, because when he comes back, he's not coming back as a savior. He's coming back with a sword to judge. So right now you need to repent. You need to turn to him. And if you continue to walk the way you're walking, you're not going to be blessed. You need to turn to the Lord. You need to turn to him and find peace in him, and joy in him, and love in him, and hope in him, and strength in him. That's what you need to do. You need to escape wrath of God.
What about the Father?
The wrath of God.
What about the Father?
Listen.
The Father.
Ten Commandments.
You're neglecting the Father.
Have no other gods
before me. Shameful. Why are you neglecting the Father?
Allah is a false God.
Okay, why are you neglecting
You're
the
breaking
Father?
The Ten Commandments.
Allah is the Father.
Do not use the Lord's name in vain. You're cursing the name of Jesus by saying that he's not
why
God.
Why are you worshiping Jesus and
You're the Father? You're cursing the name of
what
Jesus.
What about the Father? What about
when
the
you're
Father?
Saying he's not God.
What about the Father?
Thou shalt not lie. Have you lied?
Have you lied?
Thou shalt not steal. Have you stolen?
Have you stolen?
I've broken commandments.
Yes.
But I've repented.
I repented.
And I've come
well.
To know Jesus.
I repented as
You've
well.
You've not come
Jesus.
To believe in Jesus.
And I know Jesus.
You need to trust in him and believe in him as your Savior. And believe in him as your King.
I believe he's the Messiah.
And believe in him as your Lord.
Believe in his
and believe in him.
There are certain
in the early
I don't
church.
This.
How did Islam prosper?
How did Islam
move forward?
Da'wah.
How was da'wah done?
Preaching. Same as you're doing right now.
Was da'wah done as preaching in the time of Muhammad?
You're preaching, yeah, for Jesus. I'm forgetting the Father.
No. Was da'wah done? Was da'wah done, sir? Was da'wah done? Was da'wah done? By preaching? No. It was done by sword.
No, it doesn't. Jesus said, yeah, I did not come with peace,
by
I came
sword.
With a sword. Jesus said
Islam
that.
Spread Jesus, by sword.
Jesus said, I did not come with peace, but I came with a sword. Rest
now,
no.
Did the Apostle Paul use any weapons?
Saul caught people.
Did the Apostle Peter use
Saul,
any weapons?
Saul was killing Christians. He was beheading them. And had them in boxes.
Yeah, he came to know
and
Jesus.
Then he wrote in your Bible.
Did they use God, weapons? Like God. No, the early church, if you read.
Why did Saul write in your Bible?
My friend, have
why
you ever read the book of Acts? Have you ever read the book of Acts?
Book of Acts, exactly.
If you read the book of Acts, the church advances by the power of the Holy Spirit, not by weapons, not by fighting, but by the power of the Holy Spirit. And they turn the world upside down. Now listen, they were murdered.
Wait, can I say this?
They were murdered. Polycarp was murdered.
There are Christians in Arab countries.
Listen,
there are Christians today,
Polycarp,
yeah, still in Arab countries.
Sir,
so it's said by the sword, yeah?
Polycarp,
how come there are Christians still
years,
there in Arab countries? How come?
80 years of age.
How come the Coptics are still there in Egypt?
80 years of age.
To this day, nobody touched them.
Eight
nobody
years,
ever touched
80
them.
80 years of age.
Explain that to me. Explain that to me.
hurt, sir.
If it's not about the sword, how come there's Christians?
How many millions of Christians were there in the Middle East a few years ago?
No, there are still
millions. How many are in the Middle East now?
People convert.
They've gone. Religion. Genocide.
There's no genocide.
Who genocided?
Nobody did genocide against
who
Christians.
Who genocided the Christians in the Middle
genocide
East?
Against
we
Christians.
Don't talk about it.
You were burning Christians at
we
the stake.
We don't talk about it.
You were burning Christians at the stake.
Who genocided the Christians
of years
in the
ago,
Middle East?
You're the one who
tens
genocide.
And millions of Christians,
you did genocide against Christians
in the last few years.
You did Christian, you did
Christian
genocide.
Church has been blown up, decimated, raped, pillaged.
Your life.
In the Middle East.
Your life.
And who was it?
Look at the Crusades.
By the Kurds?
Look at the Crusades.
No.
Look at the Crusades.
By the Iraqis?
You came to Muslim
no.
countries, tried to convert them.
By
convert
ISIS.
Them Crusades.
ISIS.
Crusades.
And where did Crusades. ISIS get their teaching
Crusades
from?
Crusades tried to convert us to Christianity.
You only have to read the Quran.
By force.
And you have 100 and odd surahs that talk about
you,
violence.
Brought you back to Christianity. Brought you back to
so
Europe.
Don't talk about
Islam. You tried to come
Islam.
With Christianity
yeah.
by force. Don't even lie. Don't even
Jesus
lie.
Christ. No, Jesus never taught about violence. Muhammad taught about violence.
You're a liar. Jesus
so any
said,
Christians,
I came with a sword. I
any Christians, any
don't
Christians
lie, lie.
Who've done violence, they're not doing it because of Jesus.
The Bible
they're
says
doing it because of hate, not because of what
what
Jesus taught. But in the Quran, there are 100 and odd verses,
I can get you so many
100 verses that talk about
killing,
jihad.
Killing babies.
This politically correct age wants
and
to put its head under the tarpet.
The
political correct age says, oh, you're
no
Islamophobic.
Leader.
But just read your Quran
Psalms,
and tell me if I'm Islamophobic.
No,
I'll tell you what
Psalms.
You are. You're brainophobic because
that.
You ain't using
get
your brain
girls,
and reading your Quran and finding out what the Quran teaches.
It is wrong to
Jesus
fight.
Teaches about love. He teaches about his love for
Jesus
you.
Said,
that he loved you and died for you. And there's power in that
Bible,
love.
Man.
There's power in him.
Don't
I love this hymn.
Don't
oh, the deep, deep love of Jesus.
It is
past unmeasured, boundless free.
We love Jesus more than you love.
Rolling as a might. No, you don't.
Yes,
you
do.
Dishonor Jesus.
No, we don't. We pray like
you
Jesus.
You dishonor
we
him.
Like Jesus. We don't
you
do
dishonor the word.
How many pork have you eaten?
You don't even follow your own
pork?
Quran.
How much pork have you eaten?
You don't even follow your
pork?
Own Quran, sir.
Jesus never ate pork in
my
his
friend,
life.
My friend, you don't even
Jesus
follow.
Jesus never ate pork.
You don't
how
even.
How much pork have you eaten?
You don't
how
even
many
follow
sausages?
The Quran.
How many sausages?
Follow the Quran.
How many hamburgers?
Surah 634.
Jesus never ate burgers, never ate beef.
Surah 634. You don't even know your own religion.
Read it, sir. Read it.
You
read
don't
it.
Even know your own religion.
You just quote
yourself.
Go
study. Go study with these
read
imams.
It. Read it.
These hack scholars in Hyde Park.
You eat sausages every single day.
They're bullying Christians and picking on
you
them all the time.
You eat sausages every single day.
Jesus Christ.
Jesus never tasted
and these
pork.
Muslim apologists
Jesus
call it.
Never
listen,
pork.
These Muslim apologists call
don't
it. These Christian
people,
preachers
man.
Hate preachers. Stop and I was on. I was
he
watching
is.
One of these.
He's a hate preacher.
One of these Muslim apologists and one of their friends has been to Adil Shaudhry March or something like that.
It's fake.
You've got to sort yourselves out. Jesus Christ shed his blood.
He
for you
even made
gave
a video
his life
about that. Don't lie to you. Don't lie to
no,
the
no, you need to trust in
Christianity,
Jesus.
You're lying.
You need to
you're
trust
lying.
In him and look to him, sir.
You're lying.
Is it wrong to fight? Is it wrong to fight?
Adam Chowdhury went to him in his own demonstration.
As a Christian,
he never went to him.
To
don't lie to
the vengeance,
people.
Yes. The state, if you read Paul, Paul says the state.
Saul, not Paul.
No,
Saul.
Paul says that the state
Saul, the
has
was
the sword to judge, yeah? So the state has the right. So if you become a Christian and you join the state and there's an army, you can fight. But personally, you cannot take up arms and start kicking off everywhere.
So in an Islamic state, can I kill someone just like that? If I am a Muslim, can I kill a Christian just like that?
No, because
in an Islamic
no,
state,
because in your because in your Quran it says in war. Sorry.
You can lie, you became Muslim all day.
In your Quran,
like when the Christians run over Muslims outside their mosque.
In your Quran,
just like when the Christians throw
acid
in the Muslim people's faces.
In your Quran, listen, in your Quran,
they are Christians. When the Christians throw the acid in the Muslim faces, it's okay, yeah?
Listen, this is in your Quran.
When the Christians run over the Muslims outside their mosque, it's okay.
I'll become a Muslim. I'll become a Muslim.
That's okay.
I'll become a Muslim.
So it's okay for you. It's okay for you. And it's wrong for us.
Listen,
only because you follow Jesus.
Okay.
Yeah?
Sir,
is that okay to throw acid in people's faces? That calm?
Okay.
On women's
huh?
faces.
That's
Quran.
Okay.
Sir, Quran. Let's
is
get back
okay?
to the Quran. Let's
is,
get back
is
to
is
your
that
Quran.
Okay? Yeah? Only because we were Muslim. If we were like the Jews, we
let
have
me get
the cash.
Back to your Quran.
You won't do that.
Let
huh?
me get back to your Quran.
Only because
okay.
we're quiet.
Sir,
no, no, no.
Let's go to the Quran.
Only because we're
let's
quiet.
Let's get back to
if
the Quran.
If we were just like the Jews,
I'll become a Muslim right now. I'll become a Muslim. Explain to
you. You won't dare come next
explain
to us.
Explain to me.
But just because
explain.
We are quiet.
Give me a hug, sir.
And the Quran teaches us to be quiet.
Give me a hug.
Because,
hug me, bro.
I'm fine.
Come on,
I love you.
Show me some love.
Islam teaches me to love you.
Give me a hug.
Islam teaches me to love you. I love you. From the inside of my heart, I love you.
Give it to me, bro. Come on.
And I hope.
Give it to me.
I hope over the days you will actually find out the true religion and Islam.
Let's talk about your Quran. Let's talk about your Quran. Let's talk about your Quran.
It's not Christianity.
I'll become a Muslim right now. I'll become a Muslim.
I'm sorry.
I'll become a Muslim right now if you explain to me this.
I apologize.
In the Quran. Right? I'll become a Muslim right now if you explain. In the Quran, it talks about in war that you can crucify your enemy. Crucify them. And
the
chop
Bible,
off. And chop.
Baby's head.
Chop off their hands. Is that just.
What about you and the bomb that dropped a Muslim's head?
End of debate. End of debate.
End of debate. End of debate. End of debate.
End of debate. End of debate. Game over. Game over. Game over. Game over. Game over.
You're a liar.
Now let's get back to Jesus.
What about the Old Testament?
Let's get back to Jesus.
You bombed the Muslims. What happened to the body? What happened to the body?
Isn't Jesus God?
Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. Jesus showed his love.
Speaker's caller.
Jesus Christ. What you like.
You are the biggest, my friend, Muslims are the biggest cherry pickers of verses in the world. You are so bad. You pick, cherry pick all the time. You cherry pick the Bible. You say Jesus isn't God, and you cherry pick all the time. You're a cherry picker.
Where did he say that Jesus?
Muslims are cherry picker.
Where did he say that?
I have a cherry pick.
Jesus had a God.
What I have told you is scholarship. I am giving you scholarship. I can give you the scholarship of what I've just said. I come prepared. I did 2 days intensive study before I came down. I studied your Islamic apologies. I have all my information here. Look.
Is Jesus God?
I come with scholarship.
Okay. What's up?
And your Quran.
They're black papers.
And your Quran.
Okay, what's up?
They're black.
It can be anything. It can be anything in that folder, anything.
That's a lie.
What's up? It can be anything, man. It's nothing.
I come with scholarship, and in your Quran it teaches that in war you can crucify your enemy.
Jesus God.
That's an absolute joke. Absolute anathema. That is not true.
In war you disintegrate your enemy.
You need Jesus Christ as your Savior. You need Christ as the Lord.
You need him as your king.
Okay, okay, so that's Jesus God. Okay.
You do it every single time.
Times one times one, what is that?
Seven.
It's Jesus God.
One plus one plus one.
One times one.
One plus one plus
one. One times one times one.
One plus one
times one times one. What is it?
It's Jesus God.
Answer the question.
It's Jesus God.
One times one times one.
You try to justify your belief.
It's Jesus God.
You're not answering
illogic.
The question.
It's illogical.
Jesus Christ shed his blood for you. He gave his life. And that's what you need.
Who said this? God saved Jesus.
That's what you need. You need Christ in your life. You need Christ as your Savior. Jesus said this.
It's Jesus God.
I'm a liar.
Yes, because God saved Jesus. When God said, when Jesus said, God, why have you forsaken me? I believe God didn't forsake him. I believe God saved him. That's what I believe. I do not believe Jesus. God forsaken Jesus.
Jesus.
Who said this?
Jesus rose from the dead.
No,
he so he was not forsaken.
He didn't rise from the dead.
Jesus,
you only die once.
Said this.
You only die
I
once.
Am the vine.
When he comes back, he's going
to
die.
I am the vine and you are the branches. You need to be in the vine. Jesus said.
So Jesus is going to come back
Paul
and die twice.
Said, Paul
Jesus
said.
Die twice.
Paul said this. Why? Paul said How's this, my fair? Friend. Paul said this. In Paul said, in Christ, 216 times, in Christ. You need to be in Christ. You need to be in Him. You need to be in the Lord.
Who is He?
You're walking in the way of Adam, the way of the world, the way of the flesh, the way of pride, the way of sin. You are not free from your sin. You have not broken free from it. You are captured by your lust. You are captured by your own nature. You have not broken from it. And you have come in under bondage with Sharia law. Sharia law is putting you under bondage. And God has set you free. Christ has set you free. Christ has set you free from it. Christ has set you free.
The Bible is the same.
He set you free.
What's that? The Christian law and the Sharia law is the same. Go read the Old Testament. It's the exact same.
We're not under Sharia law.
It's Jesus Christ.
We're not under law.
The Old Testament law, and the Sharia law is the same.
Tell me what law. Tell me the laws.
Your Christian law, that God set down.
I'll give you a 101 in Christian theology. There are three kinds of laws in the Old Testament. There is the ceremonial law, okay? Ceremonial. Okay. Then there's national law, and then there are 10 commandments. The ceremonial laws were for Israel, and the national laws were for Israel. The Ten Commandments are for all time. The Ten Commandments can be summed up as this: love your neighbor as yourself. So the Ten Commandments still stand today, but we obey them in the power of the Holy Spirit.
Was there no sanction?
But the ceremonial law, listen, so no. The ceremonial law, we're not under that. What you're doing in Islam is you're taking us back to the ceremonial law.
So God was wrong.
You're taking us back to bondage.
So God was wrong.
You're taking us back to bondage.
What's wrong with that?
You're taking us back to bondage.
Sanctioned killing.
And you're bringing people into bondage.
No, what is wrong with
that? And binding people.
What is wrong with that?
And Jesus came.
What is wrong with the law of God? What's wrong with
it? Is it right to throw homosexuals?
Okay, if God said that.
And kill homosexuals.
If God said that, what's wrong with it?
I've just explained.
If God said that, why is this wrong with it?
Because we're not under the law, the ceremonial law.
Okay, so what's wrong with
that? That was Jesus, right?
In the Gospel of John.
Are you calling it injustice?
In the Gospel of John, it says the law was given by Moses, but Jesus came with grace and truth.
What about the Old
Testament? We're in a dispensation of the grace and truth of Jesus.
Is it injustice?
And Jesus Christ died for homosexuals, so we don't throw homosexuals off buildings like they do in Islamic countries.
So God was wrong.
We show them mercy and we preach the gospel to them. And we tell them the love of Jesus. We tell them that they can find the love of Jesus. But in Islam, you have the Sharia law. And gay people.
I correct you.
Jesus Christ shed his blood for you. He gave his life for you. And you need that power. You need that joy. You need that love. You need that goodness in your life. Jesus loved you. He trusted him.
Loved
him.
Turn
to him.
Turn
to the Lord. Today, come away before you end up in hell.
Hallelujah.
All the wrath of God will come upon you. So come out and come to the blessings of Jesus, who took the wrath that you deserve. When he died on that cross, he died as a loving Savior. So trust him.
Is Jesus the author of the Old Testament?
Shake my hand.
Is he the author of the Old Testament?
Who?
Is it in the Bible?
I love you, Muslims. I love you. Yeah, God bless. I don't say this in
any way. I have to correct you. ISIS, thank you.